Jeff Slaughter here, welcoming you to my VBS World Tour, my first VBS in partnership with Brentwood VBS Kids. When we first started working on ideas for this, I called together a group of children's pastors that I've worked with in ministry for many years, who I love and trust. And we began to talk about what direction the Lord wanted us to go. And as we were praying through it, we found out about a survey that was taken where kids were asked a question: do you believe there's anything you can do that would make God stop loving you? Over 85% of the kids said yes. And that broke our hearts. And we thought, we know where to go now. Every day your kids are going to be reminded that God loves them, and there's going to be another truth to go along with that to reinforce the fact even more. The first day of VBS, we're focusing on Psalm 139. It's always been one of my favorite passages of scripture, mainly because when I moved to Nashville in 1985 to go to college, I boarded with an elderly lady named Minerva Alexander, and this was her favorite passage. She quoted it all the time, and I can still remember her saying it to me. And it always impressed me because the intimacy of this chapter is absolutely beautiful, how it talks about that the Lord knows everything about us. There's nowhere that we can go that He doesn't go with us. He knit us together in our mother's womb. And I love when it says how vast are His thoughts about us. I love the fact that on this day, we get to teach our kids that the Lord thinks about them that way, that He loves them that way, that He knows them, He knows their name, and He has great plans for them. Welcome to Africa, you guys. Actually, Uganda, where one of the national languages is Swahili. So we're going to sing a little Swahili tonight in our concert. I'm going to teach you a phrase. It goes like this. Mungu anakupenda. Got that? Really slowly, we're going to say Mungu anakupenda, which means God loves us. And there's nothing we can do to stop that, okay? So let me tell you some facts about Uganda. Stop it. Brief. All right, so Uganda is 84% Christian, and which is awesome. And their motto is actually, "For God and my country." Stop it. Day three takes us to India, and I really wish we were in India because I love Indian food. Big fan of curry. I hope you are too, and if you haven't tried it, you need to. I also love the fact that we're showing our kids the creativity of the Lord around the world, the different skin colors, the different languages, the colors, the musical sounds, the rhythms, flavors. All of these things came from the mind of God. And sometimes we tend to be fearful of things that are different, but God says different is beautiful. And we see that all throughout the world. And though we may do different things different ways, as Christians, we serve one true God all around the world. God is the eye. God is the eye. Buenos dias, como esta? Welcome to South America and the country of Brazil, the largest country in South America, the country that has the second highest population of Christianity in the world. Thank you, Lord. The Amazon River is there. And you notice over here, the Christ the Redeemer statue that overlooks the entire city and is one of the seven modern wonders of the world. Ay, ay, ay.
Do. And what you say, and what you do. Oh,
Well, I know it's been a whirlwind, but we made it. I hope you're not too jet lagged. We're wrapping it up today talking about worship, worshiping the same God all around the world. I love the story we're sharing today with the kids, all about after they had completed Solomon's temple and they went into worship, and it said the glory cloud of God descended, filled the temple, and they were on their faces, on their knees, bowing down to worship. Our scripture verse for today is Psalm 145:3. Lord, you are great. You are really worthy of praise. No one can completely understand how great you are. I knew that the song today had to be a song of worship. It had to be an hallelujah song. Years ago, I heard someone say that the word hallelujah is the same no matter where you go in the world. You can go to any country in this world and say hallelujah, and they know what you're saying. To test this out, I went to a website that translates words, and I typed in hallelujah at the top, and then you can click on, they have lists of every language that they know of, and you click on the different languages, and it interprets the word. So as I sat there, and I'd click on each of language, it would say, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I thought, only God could do that. And people can say there is no God. They can say it doesn't exist. But he does. And that one fact proves it beyond a shadow of a doubt. That the only word in this world that is the same no matter where you go is the word that connects one people in one world to one God. One word of worship. Hallelujah. When the children of the world sing hallelujah, it's the word that never changes, no matter what the language, and the sound that is heard brings heaven to earth. Hallelujah. We're not about perfection, we're about passion and worshiping the Lord with our kids this week and helping them to grow deeper in their relationship with Jesus. So we got a lot of rehearsing to do, so we need to get going. But I speak blessing and favor over you. I speak inspiration. I speak coordination over you. I love you guys. I bless you guys. So let's get cracking.